I would like to welcome you all to this talk, which I am going to give. Actually, this one is going to be a joint exploration. Yeah, I am not going to tell you that this is right or this is wrong or this is the way you should do it, but I am going to hopefully inspire you to think what should be the process, what should be your own thinking in this matter of IQ, EQ, and SQ. Yeah. So I will just start off with a very small PowerPoint that I have put together. Now, in today's topic, hum teen aspects pe baat kar rahe hain. One is intelligence, which is IQ, which is buddhi. You know, it is everybody knows IQ. Genius jo bolte hain na. So everybody understands this is IQ, and you will find on the internet and in your studies and education many ways how to improve IQ. So there are different techniques. Koi bolta hai ki aapko jyada padhna chahiye, koi bolta hai ki aapko mathematics mein karna chahiye, koi bolega ki mantra chanting karna chahiye. So many techniques are involved in improving IQ. So a lot of emphasis is there on how to improve IQ. And so this is one part of the story. Now, the second part of the story is about how to improve your emotional intelligence. Because first, actually, maybe we're talking about 30, 40 years ago, everybody spoke only about IQ. Pehle to intelligence ki hi baat hoti thi. Ki agar aap life mein successful hona hai, to aapka intelligence, buddhi jo hai, ekdam टॉप में रहना चाहिए. सो 140 का जो आईक्यू टेस्ट स्कोर होता है, यू शुड एम फॉर दैट. ऐसी बताते थे. इट वाज द मार्क ऑफ हाउ टू बी सक्सेसफुल, यू मस्ट हैव हाई आईक्यू. देन पीपल फाउंड कि दिस ओनली एम्फेसिस ऑन आईक्यू इज नॉट गोइंग टू डू एनीथिंग, है ना. सो वी हैव टू हैव इमोशनल कोशेंट. ओके, सो वॉट इज इमोशनल कोशेंट? कि वॉट एवर इज हैपनिंग इन लाइफ, यू शुड बी एबल टू रिमेन स्टेबल. It doesn't matter if you have high IQ, but thoda sa gadbad ho gaya and you go and jump off the terrace or hang yourself or commit suicide. There is no point. To itna IQ rakke kya fayda hai? So people said that nahin, IQ is there, but also emotional intelligence. So then about 20 years ago, a lot of emphasis started that EQ, how to improve EQ. So how to improve EQ, emotional states. So people started talking about, doing yoga and doing meditation and, how to calm your mind, how to think positive. So all this movement started on EQ, which is emotional quotient, emotional intelligence. Anna. Then they found that you may have intelligence, you may have emotional quotient, but if you don't have social skills, you can't be successful. So this entire thing, now in the recent 5-10 years, there is a new thing called SQ, which is social quotient. So social quotient pe jo hai, there is a lot of emphasis. It doesn't matter if you have intelligence, doesn't matter if you have EQ, but unless you are able to inclusively move with society, make society understand you, make society engage with you, make society recognize you, make society a part of you, then there is no point. Then you can be somewhere, somebody living in Himalayas with a lot of IQ and EQ, but the society will not interact with you. So that is also a part of your success. So yes, social skills, emotional stability, and intelligence, all these three things, if it comes together, then they said that you have something called a whole person. And you will find there are separate methods for creating IQ, separate methods for creating EQ, and separate methods for creating SQ. जैसे एक बहुत ही प्रसिद्ध किताब छपा हुआ था कुछ बहुत साल पहले, How to Win Friends and Influence People, है ना? So in that book, it is all about social skills. How to win friends, how to influence people. Today, if you take success in life, it is a lot to do with how you interact with society. तो इसके लिए एक अलग साइंस है, आप पीएचडी कर सकते हैं जस्ट ऑन हाउ टू इंप्रूव योर सोशल स्किल्स. सिमिलरली ईक्यू, इमोशनल कोशेंट, इमोशनल कोशेंट कैसा आपको इंप्रूव करने का है, हाउ डू यू बिकम स्ट्रॉन्ग इमोशनली. देर आर वेरी मेनी टेक्निक्स दैट आर देयर विच आर अवेलेबल. यू कैन डू अ पीएचडी इन दिस ऑल्सो. सो देर इज अ सेपरेट ब्रांच which deals with emotional intelligence and how to improve your emotional skills. And then you have got IQ. IQ to bahut pehle se aa raha hai. So they will give you a lot of tests, special skills, mathematics, you know, association, how to take out order out of chaotic pictures. Ye sab jo hai, you know, memory, all these things, they will test and you can improve your IQ. But the problem is that we are looking at these three skills independently. Many people believe this. Many people believe is IQ, it is something that you are born with. You can improve it slightly, but you know, you can't go beyond a limit. If you are born with a limited IQ, then you will stay with limited IQ. Like that also people think. Emotional IQ also, they feel that it has a lot to do with the environment that you've grown up in. If you grow up in a family which is very stable, you know, very loving, very caring, then automatically you will have emotional IQ. If you are coming from a family which is very, having a lot of trauma, a lot of turmoil, a lot of fights, very unstable, then emotional IQ will be questioned. And then similarly, social IQ. Some people, they are extrovert. So we say, अरे वो तो बहुत extrovert person है. वो उसको तो भीड़ का कोई tension नहीं आता है. भीड़ के सामने खूब बात कर सकता है. Some people, they are experts. They are extroverts. They love meeting people. They love talking to people. So people say that is also something that is like a inborn trait. Some people are like that. You know, and then there are people who teach you how to improve your social skills. But each of this is done as an independent department. So, halaki, we want to create this center, which is the whole person. We want to create the whole human being, which is the intersection of IQ, EQ, and SQ. But we are having three separate technologies to do this. So my attempt in the next 2 hours is there something that is common to all the three? If we access that and improve that, will it automatically lead to higher IQ, SQ, and EQ? Ye hamara coach hai aaj. कि अगर ये तीन जो अब अलग 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 हम इसको देख रहे हैं, क्या इसके नीचे भी कुछ हो सकता है? अगर उसको हम इंप्रूव करें तो ऑटोमेटिकली तीनों के तीन आईक्यू, ईक्यू और एसक्यू इंप्रूव हो सकता है क्या? ये आज का एक्सप्लोरेशन है, आज का खोज है. मेरे पास आपके लिए कोई सलाह नहीं है कि ऐसी करना चाहिए, लेकिन आपके साथ में ये खोज में, ये एक्सप्लोरेशन में पार्टिसिपेट करूंगा. तो आप, यू आर गोइंग टू बी माय को एक्सप्लोरर्स. सो दिस एंटायर इंटरेक्शन फॉर द नेक्स्ट 1 hour एंड व्हाटएवर टाइम दैट वी हैव लेफ्ट, से नियरली 1 hour 45 मिनट्स दैट वी हैव लेफ्ट, इज गोइंग टू बी ओनली अबाउट एक्सप्लोरिंग वेदर ऑल दीज थ्री विच वी आर लुकिंग एट सेपरेटली नाउ, डू दे हैव सम बेसिस अंडर विच all these three are sitting? Can we go there? And if we make improvement there, or if we learn the technology of that, then automatically we will improve all IQ, EQ, and SQ. Is this possible? Now, this is actually what we are going to explore today. Okay. So in my next slide, I will actually sort of take you to this slide where I am now talking about three pictures here. And these are just random pictures I have put here. Actually, these pictures can be anything, but I have just randomly put them here so that, you know, we can get some idea of what we are speaking about. Okay. So here I have shown in the top picture where you see my red dot moving, red cursor moving. I have shown some instruments which are used by engineers or by, you know, architects or, you know, construction people or thinking people. है ना जो सोचते हैं उनके लिए कुछ tools जो इस्तेमाल करते हैं. And I say that this represents intelligence quotient. मान लीजिए कि ये जो है intelligence quotient से related है. क्योंकि अगर आप ruler, set square, divider, compass ये सब use करेंगे या हथौड़ी use करेंगे, then you will be a thinking person because you are doing something that is related to your brain activity. है ना? So that we will say, let us say that is intelligence quotient. Okay. On the right hand side at the bottom, I've shown you some railway tracks which are joining and which are dividing. And this I call social quotient because this picture represents our interaction with people. And people come together, people move apart, they interact, and it is a journey of life where you're interacting. And so this picture shows something that represents a social quotient. And then I have shown this picture, which may not be the most appropriate picture, but hunger is an emotion. So I have shown something that relates to hunger. And I have shown you some picture of cooking vessels. And I have said this picture relates to emotional quotient. So it is an aspect of emotions. Hunger is an emotion. You know, when you are hungry, many things happen to your emotions. So similarly, we have a social quotient represented by interacting railway tracks. And then we have got this intelligence quotient, which is represented by some instruments, mathematical instruments or engineering instruments. Okay. Now, you may ask, what is the point of this? You know, what is the point of this particular thing where I am talking about three pictures here. I'm talking about the one picture which is showing instruments, one picture showing railway tracks, and one picture showing vessels. Now, I can tell you that, you know, you can learn how to make these instruments. This is a science by itself. I can teach you how to make railway tracks. That is a science by itself. And I can teach you how to make these vessels. That is also a science by itself. Okay, how to make cooking vessels, how to make railway tracks, and how to make instruments. I can teach you. And these represent three different technologies. I can say that. Or I can show you this picture where I am talking about these three pictures which I showed you. They are all made of steel. Yeah. Whether you're talking about these instruments, you're talking about these railway tracks, or you're talking about these vessels, they are all made of steel only. But suppose I say that if I teach you how to make steel and how to mold steel, then you will learn how to make instruments, how to make railway tracks, and how to make vessels also. So if I teach you steel quotient, SQ, then I can automatically teach you how to make very good instruments. I can teach you how to make very good railway tracks, and I can teach you how to make very good cooking vessels. You understand what I'm saying here? Huh? See, there is a way of finding out what is underlying railway tracks, engineering instruments, and cooking vessels. If that is steel only, by learning about steel, how is steel made? How is steel molded? If I learn that technology, I can make any of these very, very beautifully. Not only this, I can make many other things out of steel also. Do you understand what I'm saying? Yeah. So in this exploration, we are trying to find out under emotional quotient, intelligence quotient, and social quotient, EQ, IQ, और SQ के नीचे क्या है जिसपे ये तीनों आधारित है? What is it that on which all these three Qs are resting? Can we access that? Is the question. Okay. So, like I gave you the example, all three are made of steels, but there is a technology which tells you how to make mathematical instruments. There is a technology which tells you how to make railway tracks. There is a technology which tells you how to make steel vessels. But if you learn how to make steel and mold steel, all the three are taken care of. So will it make sense for you to go into the underlying basis of EQ, IQ, and SQ, or try to become master of IQ, EQ, and SQ separately? Obviously, the answer is, agar ek hi patthar se teen pakshi gir sakta hai, to teen patthar istemal karne ki kya zarurat hai? I mean, what I said was, if you can take one stone and get three birds, what is the point of throwing three stones? If you can get one, three for one, then it is a festival offer now. So today we are going to explore a festival offer where understanding the one thing will give you remarkable results in the other three things. But it is an exploration. We are all going to explore this today. So let me just quickly go on to my next slide. And we are talking here about, so you can see, we have got this IQ, okay? And of course, many people have many Qs now in life. They have put in many Qs now, yeah? So they have put all kinds of new Qs also. But like I said, if you know how to make steel, you can make anything. So anyway, so first they say, before you have anything, you must have a healthy body, okay? So if you don't have a healthy body, you can't have IQ, EQ, and SQ. Of course, that is questionable. If you take people like Stephen Hawking, now his body is completely atrophied, but he was a genius in his IQ. He was a great emotional quotient, and he knew how to deal with the world. So he had all three. So anyway, but we will put it there. Then we have intelligence quotient, emotional quotient, and social quotient. But above all that, there is something called spiritual quotient. So if you have all these, then you will have a career quotient and you will have a relationship quotient. That means ghar mein bhi sab theek rahega, office mein bhi sab theek rahega. If you have all this, that means spiritual quotient is right at the top. Agar ye hai hamare paas, to iske niche sab kuch a jayenge. Aisa ek soch hai. The thought today is that if you have spiritual quotient in well under control, and if you can expand that, then social quotient automatically happens, emotional quotient automatically increases, intelligence automatically increases, and your health also becomes very good. And you will have a very happy home and you will have a very happy office also. So your career will be great. Your home and relationship will be great. So everything will be great. This is a understanding. But I need to actually explore this with you. Ki why then, if this is so obvious that spiritual quotient is the key, then why are people not talking about it so much? Ye ek rukawat jo hai spiritual quotient ke baare mein baat karne ka. अगर ये सच है कि अगर स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन है तो सब कुछ आ जाएगा हमारे पास, अगर ये इतना क्लियर है तो क्यों इस पे ज्यादा चर्चा नहीं होता? व्हाई इज इट दैट वी डोंट स्पीक टू मच अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन? दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. सो व्हाई इज इट दैट स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ टैबू? आप गूगल कीजिए, यू गूगल मेनी थिंग्स ऑन IQ, EQ एंड SQ, यू विल फाइंड मेनी मेनी थिंग्स बट वेरी लिटिल अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन. व्हाई? This is very important. If we don't understand why we don't, why there is some hesitation to bringing this word spiritual into something that is a management quotient, then why is it? This is very important for us to ask ourselves. कि ये spiritual word से क्यों हम इतना डरते हैं? अगर ये वास्तव में हमारी life में इतना important है, if it is really so important in our lives that all the other quotients are under the underlying basis of spiritual quotient, then why is it that we don't speak about it too much? Why is it that we are always thinking about something or the other than what is relevant? This is very important. So, abhi hum isko aur thodi gehrai mein hum isko dekhenge. Because the moment we bring in spirituality, religion is in the crosshairs. It is in the focus. Jab hum spirituality shabd upyog karte hain, automatically religion aa jata hai. और जो रिलीजन, जब रिलीजन आ जाता है तो एक देर इज अ ऑलरेडी ए फाइट एन इंटरनल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विच स्टार्ट्स द मोमेंट आई मेंशन स्पिरिचुअलिटी ऑटोमेटिकली रिलीजन विल बी थॉट ऑफ व्हेन आई आस्क यू आर यू स्पिरिचुअल द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट कम्स टू यू योर माइंड इज एम आई रिलीजियस डू आई गो टू अ टेम्पल डू आई प्रे टू गॉड डू आई बिलीव इन गॉड ऑल दिस स्टार्ट्स टू कम इन है ना. So if we are talking about religion, automatically this conflict starts. The moment I mention spirituality, religion comes into picture, and the moment religion comes into picture, everything else gets completely distorted. है ना, क्योंकि अभी क्या है, आज एक ऐसा जिंदगी है जहां वी हैव गॉट एको साइलोज. एको साइलोज का मतलब क्या है? वॉट आर एको साइलोज? ओके, यू टेक द न्यूज पेपर. डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेदर द न्यूज पेपर इज प्रो गवर्नमेंट और एंटी गवर्नमेंट, यू विल फाइंड वन न्यूज पेपर सेइंग एवरीथिंग द गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इज करेक्ट, एंड यू विल फाइंड अनदर सेक्शन ऑफ न्यूज पेपर विल से एवरीथिंग द गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इज रॉन्ग. सो there is no exploration, there is nobody who is talking about what exactly is happening. So depending on whether you are pro government or you are anti government, you will read the paper which is giving your point of view, but there is no exploration through your own self. Aaj ka standard TV mein kya hai, maan lijiye the topic for today is it raining outside? Is it raining outside? क्या बाहर बारिश हो रहा है क्या? ये टॉपिक है टीवी पे. लेकिन इसमें क्या होता है, एक पैनल होता है, दो लोग बोलेंगे कि बारिश नहीं हो रहा है, दो लोग बोलेंगे कि बारिश हो रहा है. सो इट विल देयर बी अ पैनल डिस्कशन, टू पीपल विल से इट इज रेनिंग, टू पीपल विल से इट इज नॉट रेनिंग, एंड दे विल फाइट विद ईच अदर. अरे अगर हाथ खिड़की के बाहर लगाए तो आपको पता चलेगा कि बारिश हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है, बट दैट द न्यूज चैनल विल नॉट से. News channel will not say what is happening, but they will take two people of opposite views, put them in the TV program, and they will watch them fight. At the end of the fight, nobody knows whether it is raining outside or not. Now, this is the problem today with, whenever we discuss spirituality or religion, immediately two camps will happen. One may believe in religion, one may not believe in religion, one may believe in spirituality, one may not believe in spirituality, it doesn't matter. But immediately there are two camps. And people don't like to discuss because this is called a controversial topic. So exploring spirituality and religion is a controversial topic. So, are udhar sab jaane ka nahi hai. Let us keep our life simple. Let us not go and discuss all this, even though we know spiritual quotient is so important, because with that you can get IQ, EQ and SQ. We will not go there too much because that is, you know, that becomes controversial. Why not go and explore? So again, what I am going to do in the next 1.5 hours with you is explore this without getting into God. Without getting into conflict, I will explore this. Because if you understand religion properly, if you understand spirituality properly, then you will find actually there is no conflict. Both are necessary in this world. See, there are many people which say, I am a spiritual person, but I am not a religious person. Then there is another person who says, I am very religious, but I don't believe in spirituality. Two camps. Here we are going to explore whether religion has its place, spirituality has its place, but what is your thinking? What is your exploration? We are not going to take somebody else's word for this. मैं तो किसी का कोटेशन इधर नहीं रखने वाला हूं आपके सामने. मैं बस आपको एक थॉट प्रोसेस जनरेट करने वाला हूं कि आप एक सोच में, सोच की गहराई में ले जाना चाहता हूं, जहां आप खुद सोचेंगे कि हाँ, रिलीजन तो रिलीजन है, उसका भी एक स्थान है हमारी समाज में. स्पिरिचुअलिटी स्पिरिचुअलिटी है, उसका भी एक स्थान है. और कैसे इन दोनों को अलग अलग और कंबाइंड समझने के बाद स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट एक्सप्लोर करने में कोई दिक्कत नहीं रहेगा. माय अटेम्प्ट हियर इज, वंस वी अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिस ऑफ रिलीजन इन अ सोसाइटी, बेसिस ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी इन अ सोसाइटी, एंड वी अंडरस्टैंड बोथ हैव देयर रोल्स टू प्ले, देन वी कैन एक्सप्लोर स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट विदाउट गेटिंग कॉट इन द नॉइज, without caught in the conflict of, अरे, he's talking about religion. Oh my God, how dare he talk about religion? Oh, he's talking about spirituality. What does he know? He says he doesn't believe in God and he says he's spiritual. All this, we don't want to get into. We want to see things as it is and we want to explore what really is spiritual quotient, how we can explore spiritual quotient, and how using spiritual quotient, I can develop my IQ, I can develop my EQ, and I can develop my SQ. So exactly 30 minutes I wanted to lay the ground for this discussion. ये 30 मिनट में मैं ये discussion का एक platform बनाना चाहता था, और exactly 30 minutes में जो है मैं ये platform बना दिया हूँ. अभी हम explore करेंगे कि क्या है रिलीजन, क्या है स्पिरिचुअलिटी, क्या है और ये सोशल कोशेंट क्या है जो हमारी जिंदगी में इतना एक महत्व स्टेटस दिया गया है, जो है जिसका स्टेटस बहुत महत्व है, उसको हम एक्सप्लोर. सो वी विल डू द पार्ट टू. सो यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू पोस्ट क्वेश्चंस. आई विल टेक देम एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स ऑफ टाइम, बट फॉर नाउ लेट अस जस्ट सॉर्ट ऑफ keep focused on this exploration. ये एक प्याज जैसा है, हम एक पील कर रहे हैं, थोड़ा 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 से हम लोग इसको पील कर रहे हैं ताकि हम अंदर की सच्चाई जो है उसको महसूस कर पाए हम लोग. We are trying to peel the onion layer by layer so that we can connect with the truth that is right inside at the heart of the onion. है ना? So now let us start again. I will go back to my screen share. So we don't want to get into this conflict of spirituality and religion. We just want to explore it. So when we do this, you have come across this example. Bahut log bolte hain ki I am very spiritual, but I am not religious. Hai na? Ye bahut ek cool statement hai. Lot of people find this very cool to say that, hey, listen, I am not a religious person, but I am spiritual. It's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Hai na? Now, when we talk about religion, ek baat aap samajh lijiye ki jab ye hum koi bhi religion agar aap le to aapko kya milega isme ki in any religion you are believing somebody else's experience. कोई भी, जो भी वो रिलीजन का हेड है, उनकी एक्सपीरियंस को आप बिलीव कर रहे हैं. दिस इज रिलीजन. आप देख लीजिए, इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ बाइबल, वी आर बिलीविंग द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ जीसस क्राइस्ट. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, लेट अस से द कुरान, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रोफेट मोहम्मद्स एक्सपीरियंस एंड वी बिलीव दैट. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हिंदुइज्म और वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनी अदर कल्चर, if we're talking about the Hebrew tradition, the Judaic tradition, we are talking about the person who created that religion whatever experience that person had, whatever truth that person had, that you believe, when you do that, you are believing in a religion. Spirituality is having your own experience. So spirituality is about your own experience. This is not based on somebody else's experience. Your own experience in life, that is your understanding of life, and that is your exploration of spirituality. What is very important here is to understand one is not better than the other. See, this is the first point I want to make. If you say, I am spiritual, I am not religious, you are in no way superior. Somebody might be saying, I am religious, I am not spiritual. That is also okay. Because religion has a place in society. Spirituality has a place in society. See, spirituality is about your own exploration. But again, if everybody in this planet, we have got 7.5 billion people in this planet, if everybody started to do their own exploration and decided how they want to live life, there will be chaos in this world. There will be absolute chaos. Because by the time they reach their own understanding of what is spirituality, they will make many mistakes. They will make many explorations. Not the first time they will get it right. So if everybody in this world is going to go through a process of making mistakes to understand their own spirituality and their own truth, you will have chaos. You will have chaos in this world, which is why religion was formed. Religion was formed to tell people, listen, we need a structure. A structure ek hona hai. O structure hone se hi samaj aage badh sakta hai. There will be order. When there is order, you can explore spirituality. Suppose there is no order. Suppose there is chaos everywhere. Can you explore spirituality? No, you cannot. First, some order has to come. Therefore, there is political order. Then there is social order. Then there is religious order. Like this, there are many orders, many frameworks, so that the society can function. This is how religion came into being. If you take some of the most ancient civilizations like our Saraswat civilization of Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, and all that, the Indus Valley civilization on the banks of the river Saraswati, they had reached a stage where they had completely all that entire civilization, all the people in that civilization had reached spiritual understanding. So there was no need for any order. Everybody knew what to do. There was no need for police. There was no need for tax officials. There was no need for. But everything was happening because everybody knew what to do. That is the height. That is where we must aim to be. But in the present day, we need order. So there is a family order. Family order is what? Yes, you can get married. Then you will have children. There is a certain relationship that you have with the wife. There will be a relationship you have with other people in the society. Your children, how they interact with other children, all this is the social order. You can't just say that, no, this is my wife, but you know, I will have relationship with many other wives. No, that is a part of social order. Yeah. And many religions will propagate this because it gives the social order. Like that, there will be a social, a political framework where there is a head of state, which might be a king, a president, a prime minister, whatever. But under them, there will be the different heads, and then there is the police, and then there is so many things. Then you get the international order. You have armies, you have got diplomatic interactions. So you have different countries, and all these countries have to stay in balance. So there is international order. Then there is order for currency and transactions. Or any transactions, you buy something from somebody, there is a certain order. There is a law. Kuch niyam hote hain, kuch kanoon hote hain. जिसकी हिसाब से एक ऑर्डर आता है. कोई भी रिलीजन में, एनी रिलीजन विल हैव ऑर्डर टू क्रिएट अ फ्रेमवर्क. इन द फ्रेमवर्क यू कैन एक्सप्लोर गॉड, यू कैन एक्सप्लोर स्पिरिचुअलिटी, यू कैन एक्सप्लोर ट्रूथ, यू कैन डू वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट, बट इट इज ए नेसेसिटी टू हैव ऑर्डर. ओके, सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. रिलीजन हैज इट्स प्लेस. If we say that religion is not there at all, then there will be chaos. You cannot bring order, which is sustainable. Because somebody will have faith. Because for example, aaj dekhiye, koi kisi ko kisi ke saath galti karta hai. Suppose somebody makes a mistake with somebody or cheats somebody, let's say. Generally, this is avoided because there is a feeling inside ki, if I cheat somebody, it is not good for my karma. Okay? Whatever it is, it gives us some order. It is important to understand religion from that context. But is religion only everything? Should we just stop at that order? That is the question. Wo question puchna chahiye. Haan, religion ka ek sthan hai samaj mein. Lekin kya hum usi pe हम लोग बैठ के चुपचाप बैठेंगे क्या, या उससे आगे भी हम कुछ खोज कर सकते हैं? दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंट एक्सप्लोरेशन. सो व्हेन आई गो बैक टू दिस स्लाइड, यू नो, आई विल जस्ट टेक यू थ्रू दिस. अभी हम देखिए कि ये थोड़ा सा, ये स्लाइड में कुछ भरा हुआ है. देर इज लॉट ऑफ मेटीरियल इन दिस स्लाइड, बट लेट अस जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड टू डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स ऑफ व्यू. जैसे मैंने बताया, हमारा समाज में हमेशा अपोजिंग व्यू रहता है. यू नो, वन सेज स्पिरिचुअल बट नॉट रिलीजियस, द अदर वन सेज रिलीजियस बट नॉट स्पिरिचुअल. इसका लक्ष्य क्या होता है? व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस? पीपल हु से दे आर स्पिरिचुअल बट नॉट रिलीजियस, दे आर नॉट एफिलिएटेड टू स्पिरिचुअल ग्रुप्स. मतलब दे डोंट फॉलो वन रिलीजन और द अदर. And they search inside themselves. The people who are saying that they are religious but not spiritual, they are always involved with one religion or the other. Well, they are not very interested in searching because they just believe what is there in the religion. They may be interested in the cultural religion or religion for religion's sake, but not for exploring something that is beyond. Hai na? वो एक इंडिविजुअल खोज में, दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड बिकॉज रिलीजन टेल्स देम हाउ टू लिव. रिलीजन आप उनको बताता है कि कैसा जीना चाहिए, सुबह उठ के क्या करना चाहिए, आपका जिंदगी कैसा बिताना चाहिए, ये सब तो रिलीजन में ऑलरेडी स्पेसिफाइड है. तो उनको खुद का एक खोज का जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ता है. तो जब आप स्पिरिचुअलिटी का साइलो, व्हेन यू टेक द साइलो ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी, it is all about searching for that truth which is divine, transcendent, and it is a boundless journey, it is an infinite journey. Iska koi ant nahi rehta hai, khoj hi rehta hai. The truth of spirituality is that it is continuously a exploration, uska ant nahi rehta hai. Then in the silo of religion, you have established institutions, like you have the churches, you've got the mosques, you have got the temples, and these help people to become good members of society. They also provide tools for spiritual development. Halanki religion mein bhi tools milta hai spiritual development ka. And most importantly, religions provide a set of beliefs, moral codes, practices and discipline. Ye point bahut hi important hai. Matlab, aapko samaj mein kaisa jeene ka hai, wo aapka religion batayega. Religion tells you how to live in society. Agar ye spirituality or religion, अगर इसका इंटरसेक्शन आप देखेंगे, तो आपको थोड़ा सा एक झलक नजर आएगा सच्चाई का. When you look at the intersection of the silo of spirituality, and the silo of religion. This center portion here is what is really what is there in this world. When you are searching for sacred as facilitated by religion, that means aap religion mante hain, lekin wo religion mein aap aapka truth ka exploration karte hain. You explore your own truth using religion. Thoughts, behaviors, and relationships are employed in the journey towards that search. This is the real confluence of spirituality and religion. Jahan spirituality and religion dono milan, in dono ka milan hota hai, tab ye point bahut important hai ki hamari soch, hamara behavior, chal chalan, aur hamari relationships, ye ek hamare liye ek tool hota hai, hamare liye ek suvidha hota hai, jiske dwara hum sachchai ki khoj mein lag jate hain. So this is very, very important for us to understand. We must not try to belittle religion, or we must not try to belittle spirituality, or we must not try to say that religion is everything or spirituality is everything. First thing, if we understand both these are there in this world for a reason, and the intersection, in dono ka jahan milan hota hai, that is what we must focus on. क्योंकि जब हम वो फोकस में जाएंगे तो स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट को टैप करने में हमें दिक्कत नहीं आएगा. वी फोकस ऑन जस्ट द इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ रिलीजन एंड स्पिरिचुअलिटी, देन आवर एक्सप्लोरेशन ऑफ सोशल कोशेंट, विच इज द अंडरलाइंग कोशेंट फॉर ऑल द अदर थ्री कोशेंट्स, बिकम्स मीनिंगफुल एंड दैट बिकम्स विदाउट नॉइज, विदाउट चैटर, विदाउट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. बिना कोई कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, बिना कोई चैटर, है ना, कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग थॉट्स, आप प्योर फोकस कर सकते हैं सोशल कोशेंट पे. समझ में आए? तो ये अभी हमारी ये खोज है. दिस इज अवर पाथ विच वी आर टेकिंग टूडे, कि हाउ कैन वी लुक एट दिस सोशल कोशेंट. सो let us quickly go further here and explore this part. Just give me a thumbs up. Are you able, Priyanka, I need your help here. Are you able to see the PPTs that I am showing every time? You're able to see them, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you. Because sometimes with Zoom, you know, ye sab kuch gadbad ho jata hai.
Right now, PPT is not on the screen.
Not on screen. Now it is on screen?
Yes, sir.
It is. Yeah. Okay. Right. Great. Super. So we are all right now. To ye ek slide humne dekh liya ki this is very important. Ki spirituality ka bhi uska sthan hai, religion ka bhi sthan hai, lekin hum concentrate karna chahiye इन दोनों की जो मिलन, सेंटर पोर्शन जो है, अगर इस पे हम ध्यान दें तो हमारा बहुत आसान होएगा ये स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट को एक्सप्लोर करने में. सो ऑफ कोर्स आई हैव गॉट सम मोर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ की स्पिरिचुअलिटी वर्सेस रिलीजियोसिटी. स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज अ वे ऑफ लाइफ, इट इज फ्लूइड, इट डज नॉट रिक्वायर कनेक्टेडनेस टू अ फॉर्मल इंस्टीट्यूशन और अ फॉर्मल डॉक्ट्रिन, दैट मीन्स अ रिलीजियस एस्टैब्लिशमेंट. It is concerned with people's individual personal interpretation of life. Spirituality is manifested in many ways, including religious practices. Hai na? Religiosity mein kya hai? Ki I have to be very devout. Mera faith bahut hona chahiye agar main religious person hu, kyunki main kisi aur ke belief ko believe karna chahta hu. To mera faith hona chahiye ki wo jo bata raha hai, whatever the person is preaching, I must have immense faith to believe it. Therefore, I must be very devout. Devotion to a religion, it denotes boundaries. Ki I am Christian, I am not Christian. I am Hindu, I am not Hindu. I am a Muslim, you are not a Muslim. To aisa boundaries aa jata hai. It is very solid. Matlab, it is, the views are very concrete. It is yes or no, black or white. इट इज यस और नो, ब्लैक और व्हाइट. वेयर इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज फ्लूइड, ये भी ठीक है वो भी ठीक है, इधर नहीं, माई वे और हाई वे. रियली इट डिफाइंस रियालिटी एंड प्रोवाइड सेंस ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस कनेक्टेड थ्रू एन इंस्टीट्यूशन और फॉर्मल डॉक्ट्रिन. देखिए ये वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट है. रिलीजियंस क्यों सक्सीड होते हैं सोसाइटी में, क्योंकि वो एक पहचान देता है आपको. सी रिलीजन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन सोसाइटी बिकॉज इट गिव्स एन इंडिविजुअल आइडेंटिटी. आई एम अ हिंदू, आई एम अ मुस्लिम, आई एम अ क्रिश्चियन, इट गिव्स मी आइडेंटिटी, इट गिव्स मी अ सोशल ग्रुप, एंड दैट इज वाई रिलीजन्स हैव सक्सीडेड. So this is one of the key things, yeah. And religions offer external formal support system. Mane ki, like for example, in any religion, for example, you know, there will be programs where we help each other, where we support each other. We have many rituals which bond people together. So all that is important in religion. So if you see this spirituality versus religiosity, actually conflict nahi hai. Both are required in at various times in differing quantities in our life. When we have no knowledge of what is the truth in our life, we need religion to give structure. But once the structure is there, we need spirituality to explore the truth, because your truth is different from my truth. आपका जो सच्चाई है मेरे सच्चाई से बहुत दूर अलग हो सकता है, इसमें कोई शक नहीं है. But your truth is your truth. And that is what you live by. Hai na? But to explore that, you need structure. To bring structure, you need religion. Religion gives you openings and opportunities for exploring spirituality. So if you see this, religion and spirituality don't have to be taboo topics. They are a part of our life. They are a part of our existence. Let us not run away from it. But let us try to understand now the spiritual core. So when we talk about this, this is very important. One understanding that you will take, and this is not a judgment. ये कोई judgment नहीं है कि religion अच्छा है या spirituality अच्छा है. लेकिन a religious person, जब ये आप उनको बताएंगे कि तुम्हें ये करने का है, अगर हमारा religion बोलता है कि तुम्हें एक करने का है, तो अगर वो सचमुच वो religion का आदमी है तो वो करेगा, चाहे वो गलत हो या सही हो. इट्स लाइक एन आर्मी, इट्स लाइक इन द आर्मी, व्हेन द कमांडर टेल्स यू गो एंड किल द एनिमी, यू डोंट थिंक अबाउट ह्यूमैनिटी एंड हाउ आई एम टेकिंग अनदर मैन्स लाइफ, वेदर इट इज करेक्ट रॉन्ग. नो, यू विल डू इट बिकॉज दैट इज वॉट यू हैव बीन टोल्ड. दैट इज रिलीजन. वेर एज अ स्पिरिचुअल पर्सन विल डू वॉट इज राइट नो मैटर वॉट ही इज टोल्ड. अगर जो भी उनको बताएगा, एक स्पिरिचुअल व्यक्ति जो है वो करेगा जो सही है, लेकिन वो सही. सो दिस राइट और रॉन्ग इज वेरी सब्जेक्टिव. अ स्पिरिचुअल पर्सन विल डू व्हाट ही थिंक्स इज राइट, बट दैट मे नॉट बी गुड फॉर सोसाइटी. यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? सी, सो स्पिरिचुअलिटी हैज गॉट इट्स लिमिटेशंस. सी, समथिंग मस्ट बी वेरी गुड. सपोज अ स्पिरिचुअल पर्सन thinks that he must do something he thinks is right, but it is not good for society, he will still go ahead and do it. Whereas a religious person, if he is told to do something because of his religion tells him to do it, he will go ahead and do it, whether it is good for society or not. So both of them independently, they have their limitations. This is very important for us to understand. Hum ye jaal mein nahi fasna chahiye ki ye sahi hai ye sahi hai. बहुत लोग सोचते हैं कि स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज अबाउट रिलीजन. इट इज नॉट. स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी, रिलीजन इज रिलीजन. बोथ हैव देयर प्लेस एंड बोथ आर अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर रियलिटी. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड. तो जब हम ये एक ट्रैप से हम बाहर निकल जाते हैं, व्हाट आई एम शोइंग इन दिस पिक्चर इज दैट व्हेन वी कम आउट ऑफ दिस चेन्स of this trapped feeling of spirituality is better than religion or religion is better than spirituality, then we become free birds to explore spiritual quotient. This is very important, how we can explore the spiritual quotient. So if we look at this picture, Now, when we look at this picture, we don't say whether spirituality is better or religion is better, but we understand the difference. Religion is a part of this ocean of spirituality, but spirituality by itself cannot give you the framework to exist in it. You require religion, you require spirituality, and that is why you have this way of exploring this. Okay, so now let us come to understanding what is spiritual core. Now, when we understand, try to explore what is spiritual quotient. First of all, the first thing that spirituality teaches you is to understand that we must accept whatever there is in our life as it is. This is the first point of spirituality. The first point of spirituality is whatever is. This is not religion I'm talking about. This is a spiritual quotient ka first. I'm giving you now the technology. Like I showed you in the picture, agar steel banane, if you understand how to make and mold steel, you can make intellectual quotient, you can make emotional quotient, you can make social quotient. You can make railway tracks, cooking vessels, and engineering instruments. Hai na? Here we are talking about spiritual quotient. And I will tell you, first thing is to understand that everything exists as it is. That is, you are seeing something and you are labeling this is good or this is bad. They are opposite, hai na? Opposite views. Hai na? You're seeing something. Okay, today something is happening in Afghanistan, let us say. So immediately we are saying this is what is happening in Afghanistan is good or it is bad. But understanding that whatever, and immediately the moment that feeling comes ki it is good or bad, then our entire thinking process and how we respond or react to it becomes automatic. अगर कोई भी चीज हमारी जिंदगी में हम उसको लेबल करेंगे ये अच्छा है ये बुरा है, इमीडिएटली हमारी माइंड में वो एक चाल चलन एक चलन चित्र स्टार्ट हो जाता है, मूवी स्टार्ट्स, रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्ट्स, हाउ टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू दैट. इफ वी लाइक समथिंग वी विल रिस्पॉन्ड इन अ सर्टन वे, इफ वी डोंट लाइक समथिंग वी विल रिस्पॉन्ड इन अ सर्टन वे, एंड इमीडिएटली स्ट्रेस विल स्टार्ट. सपोज वॉट यू डोंट लाइक इज हैपनिंग इन योर लाइफ, the first thing that will happen is you will start getting stressed. When you start getting stressed, you can't think clearly. Aapka sochne ka jo capacity hai, wo ekdam kam ho jata hai. Jab aap stress mein hain, to kya aap soch sakte hain kya clearly? Nahi soch sakte hain. This is a fundamental law. It is a law of our existence. The moment I have put a judgment on something, I am unable to think clearly how to respond to it. Because the moment I put a judgment, some other recording starts in my mind. Oh, ye theek nahi hai, to are ye dekho kya kar raha hai, sab kuch galat kar raha hai, kitne baar main bataya ye nahi karne ka hai, you know, all that recording starts, you know, I told that person 100 times not to do this, now look, that person gone and done it again. So that person has done something wrong. The moment I have put that negative, I cannot respond to what is happening because I am caught in something. Understanding that this person is like this, he has done something, and the situation exists now where I need to involve myself either to accept it, correct it, or make changes or reverse it. That for me to get into that thought process of what I should do, I should first of all become aware that I am putting this judgment of right or wrong. Anything in our life, any moment of our life, we are constantly putting. Even now as I'm speaking to you, in your mind there is an internal dialogue going on. Is what he is saying is correct? Some people feel what I am saying is correct. Immediately your thought process will be, oh, he's talking sense. Hey, even I also thought, I also think like this only. Then there'll be some people saying, what nonsense is he talking about? कुछ भी बकवास कर रहा है इधर बैठ के, एक घंटा हो गया अभी बकवास कर रहा है, कुछ भी कुछ ढंग की बात ही नहीं कर रहा है. द मोमेंट इट हैपेंस यू हैव लॉस्ट. चाहे आप सोचे कि मैं ठीक बता रहा हूं या गलत बता रहा हूं, मैं जो बता रहा हूं उसका उसका वो मैसेज आपने खो चुके हैं. The moment you put a judgment on what I am saying, as I am talking, there is an internal dialogue, whether I am talking correctly or I am saying the wrong thing. The moment you say, I am saying the right thing, a recorded way of responding to that. See, I also kept thinking like this only. This is exactly what, and I read it somewhere also. You know, nowadays, what he is saying is absolutely what I am, in my mind, I am thinking like this only. Then somebody else might be saying, "Arre, what nonsense is he talking?" But both will take away from the message that I am giving. You understand what I am saying? In this moment, if you just listen to what I am saying without putting a judgment of what I am saying is right or what I am saying is that wrong, at this moment, you understand. It is an experience. You experience what I am saying. You are not listening to what I am saying. The moment right now, if you are listening to me without putting judgment, right or wrong, you will experience what I am saying. No need to listen. You will experience what I am saying. This accept the world as it is, people, situations, events, accepting what it is will allow you to experience it and take the correct step to engage with it. Let's say Afghanistan happens. If somebody responds to it with a judgment, it will not be a response. You will create more chaos. But if you understand what is happening, okay, this has happened. Now let us accept this has happened. Why this has happened, that's another story. Okay, it is like, suppose you are going in a train. Let us say you are going from Bangalore to Delhi, and in between Hyderabad is there. And at Hyderabad, you have to get down because this train goes to Delhi. At Hyderabad, you have to get down because you have to take a train to Calcutta, let us say. Okay, now you sit in the train. You're going to Hyderabad. Hyderabad comes middle of the night. You have put an alarm clock to get up so that you can get down at that station. Alarm clock does not go off. You get up. When you get up, you're already in Nagpur. Spiritual quotient is accepting the fact that I have missed Hyderabad. I have reached Nagpur now. What should I do about it? First of all, let me get down. And then let me find out how to go to Hyderabad or Calcutta from here. This is the correct way of, this is the spiritual quotient. But normally what will happen? I told her to change the battery. From 2 weeks, 2 months, I have been telling mera alarm clock ka battery change karo. Lekin nahi kya na. Tabhi to ye miss ho gaya. Tabhi to dekho mera halat kya ho gaya. This is what normally happens. This is when you don't have spiritual quotient, you don't have emotional quotient. You get off center. But if you have spiritual quotient, and if you understand the laws of spiritual quotient, the first example I am giving you is accepting everything as it is without judging. Alarm clock did not go off. This is the fact. You missed Hyderabad because you are sleeping. This is fact. You woke up, you are in Nagpur. This is fact. This is the only fact. But why your mind is going to blame your wife or your husband because they did not change the battery? This is lack of emotional quotient coming from lack of spiritual quotient. If your spiritual quotient is there, anything that is happening in life, all emotional quotient will be taken care of if you understand the laws of spiritual quotient. If you understand the laws of spiritual quotient, all your emotional quotient will be taken care of. And this is just one small example I'm giving. So let us go back to my slide. I've got a few more examples of how this works. So in Art of Living, organization which I belong to, we call these sutras. Sutras are like little keys to living. Yeah, keys, mantras. Okay, so the first one, the one that I was talking to you about was accepting people and situations as they are. You know, so first thing, like I told you, you have missed the station. You are sleeping. You are gone. The station is gone. Let us now accept the situation and see how we need to respond without putting a judgment on the situation you are in is good or bad. This is the first thing. The second sutra is this one, which is called living in the present moment. Okay? This living in the present moment is an extremely important part of spiritual quotient. What is living in this present moment? It's very interesting. Any time you take, okay, you just think your mind where it is, yeah? Always, our nature of human mind is either we are thinking of the past or we are thinking of the future. Jab bhi aap dekhenge, aap jab sochte hain, to past ka thoughts aayega ya future ka aashayein, wishes, hopes, they will be, or future planning will be there, hai na? Now, when you think of past, mostly what you will get, arre, aisa hona tha. Agar main wo nahi kiya, if I had not done that at that time, I would not be here. I would, you know, things would have been different. You know, I made a big mistake. I did this, I did that. So many things you have which talk to you about the past, which make you feel very small. Future, even worse. Arre, with this COVID and all that has happened, now what is going to happen to my future? How is my job going to be? Should I get married? Should I not get married? Should I have children? Do I bring children into this world? I don't even know what is happening. Climate change is happening. COVID has happened. I don't know what is happening in life. Anxiety. So either regret or anxiety, 90% of the time we are here only. Pendulum either hai ya pendulum either hai. Both are opposites. But where can you deal with your life? Your life, you can deal only now. In this present moment only, you can deal with your life. This is the key of spiritual quotient. Understanding that if I have to make a difference in my life, I have to act now. I cannot act in future. What is past, I cannot change. Dropping the past and dropping the future, you are left with the present moment where you can actually make a difference. Even if you have to plan for tomorrow, that planning will happen in the present moment only. Na? Understanding that you have to live in the present moment is a spiritual quotient. Understanding that this world as it is in this present moment, it is. If I put judgment to it, whether it is right or wrong, whether I'm feeling comfortable or uncomfortable, then I am not engaging with the world. I am only doing the recording, playing my purana, ghisa pita record, jo hai, wo chalu ho jata hai. Lekin I cannot respond to what is happening. This is another sutra. This is another point in improving our social quotient. If you improve this, if you are in the present moment, your social skills will become fantastic. Your emotional skills will become fantastic. Why will social skills become fantastic? See, suppose you're sitting with your friend now and you're talking to them. I am talking to you now. But if my mind is, are, you know, in the previous slide, you know, I should have changed that slide. When I was making the slide, I should have changed. If I'm thinking of that, can I connect with you? No. If I'm thinking of, oh my God, after this, there's going to be question and answer sessions. I hope they don't ask some terrible questions, which I can't answer. Fir toh main ek buddhu jaisa lag jaunga. You know, I'll look like a fool if they ask me questions that I can't answer. If I'm thinking of that, can I connect with you? I can connect with you if I'm 100% with you now. If I am with you in this moment 100%, I'm connected with you. And you relate to me. This is social skill. Social skill is being 100% where you are. This is technology. Ye skill aap mein aa jayega, to baaki skill, emotional and aapka jo social skills, wo to apne aap badh jayenge. ऐसी बहुत सारी सूत्र है हमारे पास, बट सम इंपॉर्टेंट वंस आई वॉन्टेड टू शेयर विथ यू. ऑपोजिट्स आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री, ये एक सूत्र है जो बहुत ही गजब अद्भुत सूत्र है. ऑपोजिट्स आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री. व्हाट इज ऑपोजिट्स आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री? अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट फॉर अ हीरो टू लुक गुड इन अ पिक्चर द विलन हैज टू एक्ट वेरी वेल. Then only there's the experience of the movie. You imagine the movie. एक चलनचित्र का आप महसूस कीजिए जिसमें सिर्फ हीरो है, कोई विलन ही नहीं है. कोई ऐसा घटना नहीं होता है पिक्चर में जहां विलन हीरो को कोई तकलीफ नहीं आता है. There is no event that causes problems for the hero. There is only hero in the movie. And he just keeps winning. There is nothing, no challenge. Is that a good movie? Will anybody go and see that movie? No. The movie is good only when there is a hero and there is a villain. Aapka zindagi bhi, it becomes rich when there are opposites. Don't think that one is good, one is bad. Both are necessary. In Japan, in Japanese culture, in Buddhism, we call it yin yang, balancing. The universe is created like that. If mankind becomes too destructive to the planet will release a COVID virus. Shant ho jata hai planet. This is yin yang balance. Opposites are complementary. Everything in our life, suppose we are working very hard, automatically the desire to lie down and rest will come. When you are rested, automatically you will get up and go into activity. This is how it is. You take anything in life, there is a cycle, there is an up, there is a down. Understanding that opposites are complementary. Jab aapka business achha chal raha hai, always remember, uske piche piche jo hai, thoda sa kuch hoega, which will bring your business to ground level also. Aap samjhiye ki society mein aapka popularity bahut badh raha hai. Just remember, something will happen to bring you down to earth. This is how creation happens. Understanding that opposites are complementary. It is like a coin, 10 rupee coin. Agar usko aadha aadha kar diya, to koi moolya nahi hai dono piece ke liye. If you cut a coin in half, both halves don't have any value. But only when they come together, one is heads, one is tails, opposite. Only when the two come together, it becomes a 10 rupee coin. Life is like that. Understanding that whoever, we think that some people are such terrible people. How are they having so much success in life? They are the worst kind of people. How are they having success in life? And then there is somebody who's such a good person, but he is suffering. Morning to night, he is suffering. All these conflicts. When you understand that opposites are complementary, anything that goes up must come down. Anything that goes down must come up. This is spiritual quotient. Understanding this frees you. हाँ ठीक है, आजकल जिंदगी थोड़ा कष्ट में गुजर रहा है, कोई बात नहीं, इसका भी टर्न होएगा. I will also have my good days. When you are having very good days, don't become arrogant. Don't start telling people how to live life. This one, just because you are doing well, you'll go and tell everybody how to live life. Because you will also get your down also. It is yin yang. Yin yang. Opposites are complementary. You know? So when you understand spiritual quotient, EQ and SQ, social quotient and emotional quotient are guaranteed. But what about intelligence quotient? What about intelligence quotient? This is very interesting. when you are in the present moment and you are 100% in the present moment and you accept everything because opposites are complementary. When you are in that expanded state, when your state, you feel you expanded because there is no stress. जब स्ट्रेस होता है तो हम एक छोटापन महसूस करते हैं. जब कोई स्ट्रेस नहीं रहता हमारी लाइफ में. एंड व्हाई इज देयर इज नो स्ट्रेस? बिकॉज़ यू एक्सेप्ट एवरीथिंग. यू से ओके. इट इज नॉट दैट एक्सेप्ट मींस यू आर गोइंग टू आप सिर झुक के जो है उसके अंदर नीचे जाने का है, ऐसा नहीं. आई एम नॉट सेइंग एक्सेप्टेंस मींस गिविंग अप. नो, यू विल रिस्पॉन्ड विदाउट जजमेंट. दैट इज एक्सेप्टेंस. व्हेन यू नो and experience that, then there is no stress in life. You become expanded. When you expand, something beautiful happens. Knowledge comes through intuition. Do you know Einstein, when he came up with the formula E is equal to MC squared, ye aapne suna hoga. Einstein jo E is equal to MC squared, energy is equal to mass times square of the speed of light. This is what is driving all our planet now, na? Energy, interconversion of mass and energy. This is what is driving the planet. Ye formula jab unke man mein aaya, wo ek intuitive thought tha. It was not his intelligence that gave him the formula. His intelligence made him work on the formula. But the formula comes through intuition. It is intuitive thought process. Archimedes, आपने सुना होगा, Archimedes जो bathtub में ऐसा बैठा था, लेटा हुआ था पानी में, फिर तुरंत जो है उसको आया कि law of flotation, जो fundamental part of physics, it comes as an intuitive thought. Einstein को कैसा आया E is equal to MC square? एक बार वो बैठा था चेयर पे और वो एक विंडो से एक सन बीम आ रहा था, सनलाइट आ रहा था. सो ही वॉज सीइंग ए बीम ऑफ लाइट एंड ही वॉज थिंकिंग हाउ नाइस इट वुड बी इफ आई कैन वॉक ऑन दैट बीम ऑफ लाइट वेरी फास्ट. एंड सडनली इज इक्वल टू एमसी स्क्वायर. दिस इज मोर देन इंटेलिजेंस. व्हेन यू एक्सप्लोर स्पिरिचुअल क्वोशन, इंट्यूशन गेट्स वेरी रिफाइंड. Very refined. And many things you will just know. You don't need to be intelligent. You just know. This is the IQ of a higher order. Every intelligent person with 140 IQ ultimately depends on intuition to give them the final product. Agar wo final product hi aapko SQ, spiritual quotient mein aa jata hai, to intelligence आईक्यू डेवलप करने का क्या जरूरत है? योर इंट्यूटिव इन योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आप बस कुछ देखते हैं, आपको समझ में आ जाता है. आपको इंटेलिजेंस नहीं चाहिए. इंटेलिजेंस इज इनबिल्ट इनटू द इंट्यूशन ऑफ नेविगेटिंग थ्रू लाइफ. सो व्हेन वी एक्सप्लोर स्पिरिचुअल क्वोशेंट, ईक्यू, एसक्यू, आईक्यू, all of them get benefited. And to explore SQ, you don't need any, you don't need to be a religious person or a spiritual person. You just need to be who you are. So mera jo ye pehla slide jo tha, उस पे चलते हैं थोड़ा. आई विल जस्ट टेक यू टू द अर्लीस्ट स्लाइड. यू सी व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड हियर, दिस ये होल पर्सन, दिस होल पर्सन जो सेंटर में दिया गया है, दिस होल पर्सन कैन कम इफ यू एक्सप्लोर स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन. एंड देयर आर ब्यूटिफुल वेज ऑफ एक्सप्लोरिंग दिस स्पिरिचुअल क्वेश्चन. Very beautiful ways. So we will just go here just to understand a few more of these things. And when you explore this, you will also find. So very roughly, I'll just put together. Really, physical quotient, how does it come? It comes through exercise, yoga, being of service, voluntary work, seva. Intelligence quotient by intuition, tapping into universal intelligence. Some people call it Akashic records. Emotional quotient, if you understand that the present moment is inevitable and opposites are complementary, you will have very high emotional quotient. Social quotient, accepting people and situations as they are. Don't see intention behind other people's actions. That is social quotient. You'll never have to worry about making friends and influencing people if you just have these two points of your social quotient in you. And spiritual quotient is living in the present moment. It is called, in Buddhist tradition, they call it mindfulness, you know, be living with awareness. So these are very simple spiritual quotient tools. These are the laws of spiritual quotient. If we can practice these, if we can make these into our life, become a part of us, you don't have to worry about developing intelligence separately, social skills separately, emotional stability separately, because they are all integrated into this. So in this talk today, I wanted to basically focus on getting you to explore. Ek exploration tha. Ye main nahi bol raha hoon ki ye theek hai ya wo theek hai. Lekin main ye bata raha hoon ki agar aapko IQ, SQ aur EQ ko badhana hai, to agar sirf ek spiritual quotient pe aap focus karenge, kya aapko lagta hai ki baki teen apne aap iske dwara is un pe prabhav padega? I want you to think on this. I want you to think whether by exploring spiritual quotient, does it seem to you that all the other things can be expanded? This is the question that I will leave you with. And as per my discussions with Priyanka, we said that we will allow a good time for interaction. So we have half an hour now, which I would like to leave. Already I see that there are a lot of questions that are there. I would request Priyanka ji to read out questions, or I would like you to type. Agar aapko lagta hai ki kuch questions aap mujhse poochne ka hai, to zarur aap type kijiye, aur ek ek question ko jo hai main aapko dhang se main respond karne ki koshish karu.
Now we are open for the interactive session. So participants, if you are having any doubt.
Good morning, sir. Sir, this is Professor Surabhi Jain from Sagar Institute of Research and Technology. And sir, I listened your entire lecture. That was really very thought-provoking, and I inspired a lot from your lecture, sir. I just want to share my thoughts or the learning which I acquired from your lecture. That is, sir, initially I was thinking that spirituality and religious, both are the same thing, because adhyatma or dharma, dono ko hum adhiktar ek hi direction mein leke chalte hain. But aapka jo image tha, sir, jo fish wala aapne jo ek share kiya tha, ki fish ek aquarium bowl mein thi, that is religion. And when it is in the entire ocean, it is spirituality. So actually, sir, that was really very thought provoking for me, and it clear my doubts, the entire doubt which I have regarding the religious and spirituality. Exactly, because in our dharam also, I'm a Jain, and I listened so many pravachan from our Maharajis, and we came to know ki isme bahut ek deep science hota hai. But aapke lectures, it is very simple to understand the spirituality as well, because we thought it was very tough. Hum adhiktar references pe believe karte hain. We believe on the references, the experience from the others. हम उसको स्टक कर जाते हैं कि हाँ ऐसा होता है, इट मीन्स इट इज अ यूनिवर्सल ट्रुथ, बट व्हाट वी एक्सपीरियंस एंड दैट इज रियली द थिंग, जो हम अपने अनुभव से लेते हैं, दैट इज द स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट एंड सोशल कोशेंट एंड स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट. मुझे नहीं पता था कि SQ इज ऑल्सो स्टैंड फॉर स्पिरिचुअल कोशेंट, आई थॉट इट वॉज सोशल कोशेंट. सो यू ड्रॉ एंटायर क्लियर पिक्चर अबाउट दैट. So that was really very, you know, it's a great thing to listen to you. And sir, and when I was listening to you, your way of presentation, your way of talking, seriously, I was thinking ki some saint was, you know, giving his preaching. Or बहुत अच्छा positive positivity मिली सर आपके lecture से. And I note all the points. And I will keep in mind. I will write the sutras which you taught us, that always live in the present. Don't think about the past, because the pendulum is moving back and forth, and we just listening. We are was thinking about the past and worrying about the future. But what we should do? We should live in the present, so that we can be stress free and we will be happy all the time and make our community happy as well. So that is really very interesting and thought provoking. What I have no words to say, sir, but I really inspired by your session a lot, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Ruby ji, thank you so much for that kind feedback, and always very nice to know that I have touched the audience. And बहुत ही अच्छा आपने ये talk को समझा. You see, what is beautiful about you is that you are not just giving a feedback saying it was good or bad, but you are saying what touched you. That is spirituality, Surabhi. Your experience of my talk, that is your truth. That is spirituality. है ना? So it is not just saying कि हाँ आपका talk बहुत अच्छा था. Yes, it may have been good also. That is a different issue. But more than that, the way you explained what is it in that talk. You know, some slides I may have used, some messages I may have put. How they touched you. You know, how they made your experience, understanding of your truth. This is a very beautiful example of spirituality in our day-to-day life. You know, जैसे हम संत लोग लेते हैं, जैसे कबीरदास थे, सूरदास थे, they were not educated people or anything, लेकिन उनकी spiritual understanding, जो जिंदगी की spiritual understanding था, वो बहुत ही deep था, क्योंकि उनको ये सब समझ में आ गया कि अच्छा वाकई में लाइफ इस पे आधारित है, ये ट्रूथ पे आधारित है कि एवरीथिंग इज एज इट इज, यू नो. तो और जब हमारी जो इसके साथ इंटरेक्शन जजमेंट से शुरू होता है, तभी तो पूरा ड्रामा शुरू हो जाता है ना. तो दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग, इट इज देयर ट्रूथ, है ना. तो आई एम वेरी वेरी इंप्रेस्ड बाय द वे यू हैव understood what I was saying. It is very nice for me to know that you understood. And also, you are a beautiful example of a example of spirituality in a very, very common setting. Bas, I was talking, you were listening, but spirituality happened. And this is different from anything else we think about religion or spirituality or, you know, understanding, you know, whatever laws of life or whatever. This is different. Na? So this is a very beautiful example. Thank you so much, Surbhi ji, for sharing your thoughts.
Thank you so much, sir. And hope to hear you in future also, sir. Because aisi cheeze agar hum sunte rahenge, to I think life mein hum apna emotional quotient bhi develop kar payenge. Uske saath saath hum bahut si negativities se bhi dur reh sakte hain. We got, you know, इसके लिए एक डिग्री की जरूरत नहीं होती, एक अनुभव की जरूरत होती है, एक्सपीरियंस विच वी गॉट फ्रॉम द एक्सपर्ट्स, द रेनाउंड स्पीकर्स लाइक यू. सो इट्स रियली अवर प्रिविलेज, अवर सेज फैमिली प्रिविलेज, दैट वी गॉट सो मच सच अ नाइस स्पीकर विद अस. सो थैंक यू सो मच सर. एंड इफ एनी ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट, इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी क्वेरी और यू वॉन्ट टू शेयर एनी थॉट, एनी एक्सपीरियंस, प्लीज यू आर वेलकम. इफ एनी वन, I think sir, by your lecture, आपने सोचने पे मजबूर कर दिया है सभी को आज कि they are thinking. Yes, हम जो सोचते थे, एक entire turning हो गई है सबकी life की, एक अलग दिशा में मुड़ गई है सभी की life. So I think Priyanka ma'am, our participant has got a clear understanding about the topic, that is spiritual quotient. That is really very, actually ये एक दिन में समझने वाला टॉपिक नहीं है.
I think Dr. Mamata, Dr. Mamata wants to say something.
Dr. Mamata ma'am, please welcome ma'am.
Yes sir, yes sir. Good morning sir. Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Mamata ji.
Sir, really, I must say, honestly speaking, your lecture was really thought-provoking. I totally agree with the Surbhi ma'am. whatever she said, I was feeling exactly the same thing. You know, this is the first time I got to know what's the difference between spirituality and religion. And we should live with a balance between both of these. That was the real home, like take home message, what I got. And the second thing, opposites are complementary. Live in the present, live the moment. Two things is a take home message and a very positive message. Otherwise, you know, how you explain this line, opposites are complementary. I think we cannot even imagine in that way that opposites are complementary can be explained in a way that you explained it. It was wonderful. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. I think now from last 4 days, we are listening these things. And these are making a very positive impact of our, you know, daily life. So we are also thankful for this whole organization for this carrying out this type of things for us. So we really need this. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving this lecture. This was not just a lecture. It was really a thought-provoking things for us. And it will definitely, we'll try to implement that things in our life from this moment on, from the just now. Thank you so much.
Dr. Mamta ji, thank you so much for that feedback. Ye jo aapne bataya na, opposites are complementary. You know, I will take a few minutes because I have time. But ye opposites are complementary pe jo hai, I would like to just share with you some of the explorations that one does. And this happens in a course which is called Mandalvatika that I conduct. And isme jo hai, we go to the origin of creation itself. Hai na? So we go in this particular exploration. Hum srishti kaisa hua, wo point jahan srishti hota hai ye pura brahmand ka. We go there to find out how creation may have happened. Okay, so we go through the latest in quantum physics and particle physics, string theory. We do all that. And then we also go in our Vedic understanding through a sukta that is called Nasadiya Sukta. Nasadiya Sukta is one of the ultimate explorations in the Vedas of how creation happened. And it's a very beautiful sukta. Not many people talk about this particular sukta because it is very, what do you call, Gupta knowledge. It's very sacred knowledge, which normally people, it is not given to normally the people. But if you Google today, you will find a lot on Nasadiya Sukta. In Nasadiya Sukta, the Rishi who explored this Sukta, his name is Parameshti Prajapati. Parameshti Prajapati. See, we, our Saptarishis and all these names, you know, like Kashyapya, Kashyapa, Vyasa, all these people we remember, but we never remember somebody called Parameshti Prajapati. And the Devi, the Tattva, whom he explores in this particular Sukta is called Bhava Vrittam. We never hear of a god called Bhava Vrittam. We hear people have explored tattvas like Pratyangara Devi. Okay, Pratyangara Devi was not the name of the Devi. It was the Rishi who explored. His name was Pratyangara. So the Devi's name became Pratyangara. So when the Rishis explored these tattvas, these wave frequencies, they gave the names like that. So this Bhavavrittam, when the Rishi Parameshti Prajapati explored Bhavavrittam, he understood creation. He understood how creation happened. It was, he was intuitively, matlab wo universal intelligence download kiya usne information ki ye creation kaisa hua, aur usme ek sukta usme likha ved mein. In the Vedas, there is a sukta called Nasadiya Sukta, which talks about how creation happened. And it is ditto what the modern science is trying to understand. What modern science does not understand, even today, it is there in the Nasadiya Sukta. It is such a deep text. Hai na? So in this text, he talks about what happens even before the god, Devi Devatas were formed. He is talking because he says even Shiva, Brahma, Vishnu, etc. in our Hindu tradition. He says they all came after creation. Jab Srishti hua, tabhi to Devi Devata aaye Srishti mein. But he is talking about before. before that creation, what was there and how creation happened, he talks about this. And इसमें जो है उसने एक बहुत ही सुंदर एक कॉन्सेप्ट देता है कि अगर एक सुप्रीम इंटेलिजेंस इतना फैंटास्टिक ब्रह्मांड को क्रिएट करने का, इफ देयर इज अ सुप्रीम इंटेलिजेंस व्हिच वांटेड टू क्रिएट दिस एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी रिच यूनिवर्स, इट शुड हैव डन यूजिंग सम वेरी फंडामेंटल सिंपल प्रिंसिपल्स. सो व्हाट इज दैट, एंड ही टॉक्स अबाउट दिस अपोजिंग equilibrium. So he says the universe would have created the opposite. It would have created a night with a day. Then only there is the day and night cycle, there is seasons, there is everything, whatever. Everything. If there is matter, there is antimatter. If there is energy, there is dark energy. Like that. He explains that the supreme intelligence would have created a feedback loop. In modern science, we talk about a feedback loop which creates equilibrium. So in the equilibrium, evolution happens, but it is kept in balance. Okay. If there is a black hole, then there is a white hole also. Okay. If there is matter, there is antimatter. If there is positive, there is negative, like that. Yeah. So in the creation itself, by putting two opposites which keep on balancing each other, if matter becomes more, antimatter will become, make it less. If antimatter becomes more, matter will make it less. If in our life there are suddenly a lot of asuras coming, devas will come and they will bring them down. If there is too much of sattva happening, then asuras are needed to bring equilibrium. So it is not that asuras are good or devas are bad, but it is the way creation happened in this principle of balance. So whatever we talk about good and bad, they are only balancing principles. In our entire existence, whether you take physics, mathematics, you take chemistry, biology, you take spirituality, you take Vedas, you take anything, religion also, you take. It is all based on this yin-yang, balancing. Opposites are complementary because that is how creation happened. So if you are feeling suddenly very sad, you don't have to go and kill yourself. All you have to know is, I'm feeling sad now, but the opposite happiness is coming behind. So, piche piche khush bhi aa raha hai. Abhi to main dukhi hoon. Theek hai, I accept that right now I am this. But abhi iska matlab nahi hai ki main kahin se kood jaun. I don't have to kill myself because I'm feeling depressed, because piche piche happiness is coming. Just understanding that life is about up and down cycle. It is cyclical. Anything you take in this universe, it is cyclical. This is because in Nasadiya Sukta, the Rishi Parameshti Prajapati talks about the principle of creation. The principle of creation itself was to put two opposites together and let it evolve. Because as long as the two opposites are balancing each other, creation continues. This is the beauty. Without night, there is no day. Without black, there is no white. You can't say, I like white, I hate black. No, you can't, because without black, there is no white. So this understanding, because the principle of creation itself is based on opposites, balancing opposites, yin yang. Because it is based on that, our life also today, everything we experience in our life today is also based on the same principle. Of opposites are complementary.
So much, sir. Very well explained. Very well explained. And you gave a hope in these words also. Opposites are complementary. That means you gave a positive hope. Okay, if I'm sad today, the happiness is coming behind. So thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
We can have reactions also. If somebody wants to just give their reaction or response to what they felt about this talk, we have another 15 minutes to share. So anybody is welcome. Koi bhi aapka kuch baat pesh karna chahenge aapki aaj ki talk pe, to aap unmute karke aap bol sakte hain.
Sir, one question I wanted to ask. Am I audible?
Yes, you are, Dr. Jina.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, actually I wanted to know, how do we understand that we are growing spiritually?
Very interesting that you asked this question, Doctor. And I'm glad in a way you asked this, because I have to go to my last slide. 12 symptoms of spiritual awakening. Dr. Jina ji, I'm so happy you asked this question. Because ye slide main soch raha tha aapko dikhau ya na dikhau, lekin ye ek light way hai, ek bahut hi light way of looking at it. Bahut hi zyada, it is not a heavy thought process, bahut hi simply ek innocent way of looking at 12 symptoms. Agar aapko spiritual quotient ki bimari lag jaye to aap mein kya symptoms dikhega, ye एक लिस्ट मैंने बनाया हूं, तो थोड़ा सा आप हम एक एक देख सकते हैं. वन इज इंक्रीजिंग टेंडेंसी टू लेट थिंग्स हैपन रादर देन मेक देम हैपन. देखिए, हम जिंदगी में वी आर ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू मेक थिंग्स हैपन, बट व्हेन यू आर स्पिरिचुअली अवेकन्ड यू लेट थिंग्स हैपन, बिकॉज द यूनिवर्सल इंटेलिजेंस विच इज मेकिंग द थिंग्स हैपन इज फार मोर इंटेलिजेंट देन यू आर. Allowing things to happen, but being there 100% to respond to it. That is the trick of life. Second is frequent attacks of smiling. आपको बहुत बार जो है मुस्कुराहट अपने आप आपके चेहरे पे आएगा. You know, you will have frequent attacks of smiling. You have feeling of being connected with others and nature. है ना? देखिए, this is a Zoom session. And today in this session, there are 65 participants. Anna. But I am feeling connected with each one of you. I cannot see you. Many of you are with your video off. But I can feel I am connected with 65 people on this Zoom call. This connection with other people, other animals, other forms of life, with nature, this is also a symptom. Frequent overwhelming episodes of appreciation. बहुत बार जो है आपको दूसरों का या कोई घटना का appreciation आप में आएगा. You know, you feel like appreciating things around you. Fifth one, a tendency to think, act spontaneously rather than fears based on past experience. आप एक spontaneity आप में महसूस होएगा. जो भी आपका फियर्स था पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस से, अरे जब मैं छोटा था तो मैं जब सब लोगों के साथ गाना शुरू किया तो सब लोग हंसे और उसके बाद मैं गाना कभी नहीं गाया किसी के सामने. ये एक फियर, एक भय जो है, अ फियर दैट यू एज अ चाइल्ड वर बिलिटल्ड फॉर सिंगिंग और पीपल लाफ्ड एट यू व्हेन यू सैंग एंड देयरफॉर यू डिसाइडेड नेवर इन माय लाइफ आई एम गोइंग टू सिंग. That gets replaced by, okay, I just feel like singing, तो मैं गुनगुना शुरू कर दिया. That spontaneity. Unmistakable ability to enjoy each moment. हर एक क्षण, every present moment, to ability to enjoy. Loss of ability to worry. You know, your capacity to worry starts to diminish. You will actually lose ability to worry. Hai na? In life, we have understood losing ability to hear, see, think and all that. But losing ability to worry, that is something. Loss of interest in conflict. Jab aap newspaper uthayenge and dekhenge ki idhar ye khachda ho raha hai, idhar ye jagda ho raha hai, you suddenly feel a loss of interest. Varna jo hai, we are always interested in conflict. जहां भी, अरे देखो उन दोनों के बीच में झगड़ा हो गया, अरे क्या हो गया, क्या बताओ 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 बताओ, है ना. वी हैव लॉट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, है ना. बट देन यू स्लोली लूज इंटरेस्ट बिकॉज यू नो दैट दिस इज ऑल्सो अ पार्ट ऑफ व्हाट इट इज. लॉस ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन इंटरप्रिटिंग द एक्शंस ऑफ अदर्स. अरे वो सही किया, नहीं किया, डिड ही डू समथिंग प्रॉपरली, नॉट प्रॉपरली, राइट, रॉन्ग. यू लूज इंटरेस्ट इन इंटरप्रिटिंग अदर्स एक्शन. You lose interest in judging others. अरे वो अच्छा आदमी है, बुरा आदमी है. You stop that. You lose interest in judging yourself. This is very important. Are, I am a good person. I am a bad person. I am a good singer. I am a bad singer. I am hopeless at mathematics. I am hopeless at this. I am no good at this. This judging of yourself, that is even more important. And then gaining the ability to love without expecting anything. Ye 12 points hota hai. Jo symptoms hai if you are going at acquiring spiritual quotient. It's very interesting. And the last one, you know, the last two, stop judging yourself. This is very important spiritual quotient. You know? And the ability to love without expecting anything in return. You know? That ability that everybody is me, my family only. Everybody is my family only. You know, if I understand this, that I have one lung in my body, which converts oxygen to carbon dioxide, which takes in oxygen and converts it into carbon dioxide. This is one. And then my other lung is the plant, which is converting carbon dioxide to oxygen and giving back to me. If I understand this plant and my lung, mera fefda aur pauda, dono ek relationship hai. Ek oxygen ko carbon dioxide banata hai, to carbon dioxide ko oxygen banata hai dusra. अगर ये समझ ये एक्सपीरियंस होता है तो मैं कभी जाके एक ट्री को नहीं काटूंगा. आई डोंट हैव टू टीच अ चाइल्ड टू नॉट कट अ ट्री बिकॉज इफ द चाइल्ड इज टॉट हाफ योर लंग्स इज हियर हाफ योर लंग इज देयर इन द ट्री विल द चाइल्ड गो एंड डिस्ट्रॉय अ प्लांट ही विल नॉट. दिस इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी. यू नो दिस एबिलिटी टू नो दैट वी आर कनेक्टेड विद एवरीथिंग. If we are connected, why should I tell you don't cut forests? If I know that half my lung is that forest, will I cut my own lung? Mera fefda main apne aap kaatunga kya? Nahi kaatunga na. That ability to love everything and know that it is a part of you, this is spirituality. So I hope, Dr. Jina, I have answered your question. How will you know you are becoming spiritual? Thank you so much for this.
So sir, can I ask one more question?
Please.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, normally what I have seen is if we work more on our skills, we try to develop some skills, then automatically we are very good at it. So one question which always used to come in my mind is, when we do meditation, it may happen that at some time we are very good, we have attained some state, but sometimes it may happen that we are not able to attain silence and all. So is it fluctuating, like spiritual quotient, is it fluctuating? I don't know whether there is a logic in my question or not, but this many a times comes to my mind that if intelligence quotient is always there, if you're working on something, developing something, then it's there. But about if we talk about spiritual quotient, so is it fluctuating or it always goes on improving?
Yeah. So it's your question, Dr. Jina, is the question with many people who do Kriya, meditation, yoga, they all have this question because some days it will be fantastic. Some days you go into very deep meditation, to har ek cheez jo hai ati sundar hai aapki charo taraf, everything looks very beautiful, you are so calm, you're so you feel that yes, you have gone up spiritually. Then there will be a day when you have done deep meditation but nothing's happening, you are getting irritated, you are getting angry, all the spiritual knowledge goes down the drain. This is also happening. So what exactly is happening? There is a very beautiful understanding that while we may use tools for spiritual practice, spiritual understanding is not guaranteed by the practice. It can help you. Like suppose you start exercising, you will get a healthier body. But it is not guaranteed that you will not die tomorrow. It's as simple as that. It is no guarantee. Okay. But spiritual practices are important. I am not saying that they are not important. They are important, but they are no guarantee. The guarantee comes, just like you said, with intelligence, it comes from that experience. Once you have experience, let us suppose you are a great mathematician, you're dealing with matrices, let us say. Once you have experienced a matrix, just by looking at that equation or that matrix, immediately in your mind, all the answers happen. This is intelligence, which comes by 10,000 hours of skilling. Similarly, spiritual quotient also comes. It also comes, but it comes through experiencing, not practicing. Practice is important because it builds your body and mind to explore that. But spirituality is experiencing. Like I said just now, a tree and my lungs. Once I experience that this actually is one and the same. This experience for a child, if you experience for that child, if you give that experience, ki, see, this is what is happening in your lung. This is what is happening in the tree. This tree and you are one. This tree is the other half of your lung. I'm just giving a simple example. Once the child experiences this truth, it is finished. It is like that skilling. So we sometimes make the mistake of understanding practice, spiritual practice with spiritual guarantee. It has never happened like that. In fact, some of the most biggest spiritual masters, like you take, for example, Valmiki, for example, yeah, he is a spiritual person, yeah, Surdas, Kabirdas, for example, they never did any spiritual practices, but they experienced that. One time you experience that spirituality, that becomes a part for life with you. Next time, another experience, it becomes a part. After that, there is no going back. There is no going back. It is not that a spiritual practice can guarantee you that, but spiritual practice can prepare you, but it cannot guarantee you. So Dr. Jina, that subtle difference between spiritual practice and spiritual guarantee, if you get it, then this question drops.
So, sir, with your prior permission, we would like to conclude now. And really, not, I must say that you are not only a creator, as I have studied, when I introduced you in your biodata, I saw that you are the great plant lover, agriculture. You have contributed more things in agriculture for farmers. So I must say that you are not only a creator, but you are also a deep thinker. And you precise us, you make us, make me, make all the participants think deeper and deeper. Whatever the thing, aapke jo bhi hai, jo punchlines to, like the opposites are coming, and the opposites are there for balancing. It's really fantastic. Means, ye baat sahi hai ki sabhi ko pata hai, ki aaj dukhi hai, to kal khush hona hai. But we are not having the self-acceptance ki haan khush hona hai. So, lekin aapne jitne bahut beautifully tarike se jis cheezon ko explain kiya, that's really very amazing. और मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि 2 घंटे भी बहुत कम है और आपको सिर्फ लोग क्वेश्चन पूछते रहो और मैं भी इंजॉय करती रहूँ सुनती रहूँ लेकिन ड्यू टू दीज टाइम लिमिट और 2 घंटे में बिल्कुल भी पता नहीं चले अगर मैं शायद आपको 5-6 घंटे के लिए भी इनवाइट करूँ ना तो आपका क्वेश्चन द शो मस्ट गो ऑन लाइक दिस तो थैंक यू सो मच सर आई रिक्वेस्ट सुरभि मैम टू प्लीज कंक्लूड द सेशन एंड सर थैंक यू सो मच We just love your session. So it's really a privilege for us to be here, to have you. So, Surbhi ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Priyanka ma'am. And thank you once again, Dr. Rao, sir, for enlightening us with your valuable knowledge, informative information, and really very wonderful lecture. And sir, on the behalf of entire SAGE Group and Sagar Institute of Research and Technology Pharmacy, Bhopal, I would like to show my sincere gratitude. And thank you so much, sir, for your valuable time you took from your busiest schedule to enlighten us. Sir, thank you once again. And thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Have a nice day, sir.